For children and teens who have yet to know about how to best interact with people who have autism or are on the spectrum, especially if they go with their parents to World Autism Awareness Day, held at Science Centre and of course at Kids Talk too, depending where they go, and they can find out more information on the website, how would you advise them? Because sometimes people, younger children, don't know, so we won't judge them. But one thing we shouldn't do is don't stare and ask loudly, what's the matter with them? Yeah, for example?
Yes, actually, we want to be able to educate the general public about autism.
Mm-hmm.
So while children with autism might experience their own differently, they may have some social communications issues, they may move differently, but that does not mean that they are not like us. So it's important to remember that we should not ostracize them. Just like you would with anyone else, we should be respectful and patient. We should ask before we offer help. We should be sensitive about physical contact as they may have sensory processing issues. We should speak openly and directly. For example, you would describe the request very clearly, and there should only be one voice when we are communicating with them, because they have difficulty listening to two people speak at the same time. Yeah.
Okay, so very useful tips out there for us to learn, and of course these will be made available to us as well. We can just ask people from Kids Talk or Science Centre if they'd like to direct us to more resources as well. Jennifer, how else has Kids Talk catered to children of different abilities and neurodiverse leanings throughout the years?
Right, at Kids Talk at the Science Centre, our educators and our facilitators are trained to understand the different needs of learners. We also encourage our content planners to devise lessons and prepare content informed by the Universal Design for Learning Framework, UDL for short. So learner variability is a fundamental premise for UDL. So by using this framework, our programs can be catered to people with different learning styles. For example, we devise various forms of engagement, like hands-on workshops and sensory-friendly performances. We have different methods to present our info and content, as well as different ways to allow our learners to express themselves. So we've been hosting workshops for students from special education schools. We have organized various storytelling sessions by authors of books that promote inclusivity. We've also organized a research hunt in our galleries to help